Okay, welcome to IT Idiots, episode 60, I believe.
Yeah, it is indeed, yeah.
Excellent. So, how are you doing?
I'm not doing too bad.
Merry, happy new year to you and all that.
Yeah, it is still, isn't it?
Yeah. So, yeah, the last one we did, it was Christmas, wasn't it? It was like ages ago.
It was in between Christmas and New Year's, I think, wasn't it?
Yeah, lots happened since then, hasn't it, really?
It has.
So, back at work?
Back at work, yeah. Well, I didn't really finish work. I sort of worked over Christmas.
Oh, what a nightmare.
Yeah.
Well, actually, no, that's probably quite good, because I found coming back to work to be an absolute pain, so...
I didn't have that. Got a Windows 2008 exam.
Oh, yeah, so you're
qualified in that.
Qualified, are you? You're certified?
Yeah, certified in that, so watch out for some cram sessions coming soon.
Excellent.
The exam was quite straightforward, I've got to admit.
Excellent.
So that's what I've been doing.
Any news you want to impart to people, perhaps?
Oh, let me think. I don't know. What possibly... Well, let's have a look on iTunes, shall we? Yeah, there is, isn't there?
Yeah, I mean, we're well happy about this.
Yeah, so finally...
Got some recognition after 2 years, almost.
It is about 2 years, isn't it? I think we've been going now.
18 months, something like this.
Yeah, and so far, most of our subscribers have been English, which is fine, obviously.
Yeah.
And we've had a few American subscribers pop in, but now it looks like... it's gone a bit mental, hasn't it? Because we looked at the stats the other day and we thought, what the hell's going on here? I thought our server's going to go down.
Well, we doubled overnight, and we're now delivering about three times the bandwidth, aren't we?
I know.
On a daily basis. And that's because...
We're number one.
We're number one in the software how-to
in
the
US, which is quite good. So, I mean, who are we better than? Leo Laporte,
We're number one because obviously people are just finding us, and so obviously a lot of people are clicking on it and I guess subscribing. So we'd like to thank everyone out there for helping, I guess, support us really and sort of keep us going in terms of having the, I guess, the get up and go to do this every week. But we're obviously getting the recognition, and certainly you are, for the technical content you're getting across.
Well, you do all the editing and putting together, and we get great comments on that, don't we?
Yeah, I mean, have you got any comments that you might want to bring up? Because I was really taken by some of the...
Perhaps I could accidentally click on these. What's this say? Enterprise IT is not blatant advertising. Well, that's one thing I'm really happy about that one, because I do look a lot of podcasts myself, and I do feel a lot of them are swayed because of, you know, some kind of sponsorship or some kind of thing. And, you know, that's what we're really about. We say it how we feel it is.
It's true. Know? It's very, very true.
So I'm really happy about that comment. I like that one a lot. Great content, great accents.
Well, that we can't do much about.
We did invent the language, so obviously, you know, our command of it's going to be better.
So we were pleased with that anyway, weren't we?
Yeah.
We were very, very happy with that.
That.
So, yeah, I mean, anyone who's just sort of found us, head over to itidiots.com, because over there you'll also find our other show.
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah. Some of you might not be aware that we've got two shows, IT Idiots, and this is our sort of enterprise-y, PC, Windows-y one, and the other one's more focused on Macs.
Because we don't actually really like PCs, it's just
we work with them.
So we do a podcast on them. So we started one up on the Macs, which is much more, it's much more casual, the Mac one, isn't it? Because we're not in any way experts, so it's just us really exploring the Macs. Similar sort of thing, screen capture going on, and we just take a look at interesting things, and we like doing the Mac one. It's more for us. We do that one.
We do, yeah.
So,
and that's probably why we're running this one from a Mac.
So the Mac's certainly something which we would recommend. If you've got a Mac, go and check out our other show and see what you think.
Mac show, yeah, and try and get that to number two,
or number one. It doesn't matter.
Well, joint number one would be nice. So
absolutely.
The other thing.
I think so.
You know, and this is Gizmondo's site, so we ought to give credit to the websites that we go to. I think so. Gizmondo, again, a great website. But again, Vista, what the hell continues to go on?
What's going on there?
What's going on there? So,
Bill, come and defend this on this show.
I'm not overly sure on this one. Well, even Bill Gates, I think, on his interview, he was asked, is there anything you regretted or anything you shouldn't have released? And he said, ask me until the next operating system comes out before you answer that. But, I mean, check out these benchmarks. So, to network copy 1.37 gigabytes. In XP, 3.37 minutes. Not bad. Vista, 13 minutes, you know, just under 13 minutes. And those of you waiting for Service Pack 1, well, I wouldn't go there, mate. It's 1541, so that's gone up. Now,
but that's the release candidate, so that might have some debugging code in it,
well,
I
understand it doesn't have any debug code in, okay, yeah, and I suppose we can't take those final figures as a pinch of salt, but even to release the RTM with that, that for me is inexcusable. Do you know what I mean?
Inexcusable, even.
Inexcusable, whatever. I don't know. But... It's a little
unbelievable.
Even hard disk speed, you know, read 120 megabytes-ish on XP and you're down to 80 on Vista, which basically means you need to have your Stripe disk, you need to have your quad. This is driving Moore's Law, you know, this is Microsoft and Intel working together, I think. Because the only time Vista's going to perform well is when we get into quad cores.
But this doesn't make any sense. I mean, this is a step backwards. It's almost unheard of.
I really don't understand it. You know.
So you've all switched back in your office, have you?
Well, yeah, I've been using XP for a little while. My work laptop, I'm generally a VMware guy, so I use VMware a hell of a lot. And of course, hard disk speed is important with VMware. So why the hell would I run Vista? Plus, Vista gives me no benefits on XP. I'm not saying I'm against Vista. I did use it for about 6 months, I think.
Yeah, you really wanted to like it didn't you?
I do like the user interface. Aero is pointless, but I can, you know, I don't mind it. But the new Explorer I like, I like a lot of what they've done to it, but it's just not worth the cost for me, you know, and this is all my opinion again, so don't flame me or anything, but Vista is shite in my opinion.
Right, so that's that then. So, well, that's part of the reason why I bought what I've bought for today's show. So I guess we probably should show them. I guess out of curiosity more than anything else, I went out and I bought one of these Asus E's because a lot of people have been talking about them.
Yeah.
And they sort of come into the whole sort of miniature laptop that's lightweight, easy to use. But I think the most important thing is, rather than paying a premium for these now, Asus have been able to release this 7-inch machine, which is a very cut-down laptop. Let's not beat around the bush. Uh-huh. But it's £180 plus VAT. So, I mean,
is that actually really widely available in England now?
Yeah.
It is.
I mean, you will be on a slight waiting list. I mean, I managed to get hold of this next day, but it was only because they came into stock somewhere. It was on their website and I bought it. And by the time I'd finished checking out, I went back to have a look and there weren't any more available.
Yeah, because I think they go for a little bit more of a premium on eBay. You know?
Yeah. So, I mean, this is the 4 gig version in white. And the white seems to be the, I think if you want it in black, you can get hold of it. I think it's just everyone wants this pearly white sort of Mac-esque sort of look. I'm figuring that's the only reason. I wanted a white one. I don't know. Again, I don't really know why, but I just wanted a, I don't know, for some reason I wanted a white one. And I don't know about you, but it's well made, isn't it?
Well, it looks
good. Sturdy.
Yeah, and I mean, surprised. Today's the first day you brought it around. It's the first time I've actually seen one for real. I mean, I've looked and read them, and I'm quite impressed and quite looking forward to seeing what it can do.
Yeah, so we thought we'd take a look at this. I mean, let's run through the specs. I mean, I think the first thing that's of interest about this particular device is it doesn't actually have a hard drive in it.
Okay.
So when I say the 4 gig version, I don't mean 4 gig of RAM. I mean 4 gig of solid state disk.
Okay.
So essentially, you're putting the operating system onto, well, the memory stick.
Okay.
that's the way to look at it. Now, my understanding is that, and I know a lot of people were worried about this and have been sort of asking questions, is the fact that solid state disks only have a certain number of cycles that you can write to. Now, I know that the technology's moved on, or people are saying the technology's moved on an awful lot, and it comes with technology that spreads out the reading and the writing all over the place, so you get an even wear across the disk. But the general consensus from people is that if this is a lightweight machine that you're not using for 8 hours a day, but picking up when you're travelling or a little bit like browsing at home, you're going to get several years' worth of use out of this. And to be honest with you, in several years' time, let's be honest, you're not going to be using this. You're going to be using the next iteration.
So to be honest, however nice it is in IT, we know in a year you're going to not be using that, will you?
No, there'll be something better around the corner. But so I really wanted to buy this because I wanted to see for myself what £180... Okay, let's put this including the VAT. So this is like £220, I think, it was delivered. £220 delivered. I bought this online. And I think this particular model's $399 in the US. Because we've got a US audience
now. Oh, yeah, of course.
And I just couldn't believe that you would get anything for that kind of money. So what do you get? Well, you get a 7-inch screen. And we'll look at this in a bit more detail because we're going to set up the camera and actually run through booting this up. You get a 7-inch screen. It's a small keyboard, there's no denying that, and the keys are like 1 mil apart rather than the usual 5 mil that I think you've got on your keyboard.
But it's perfectly usable.
It is. It's got a camera built into it.
That surprises me.
It's obviously got microphones, speakers on the side. It's wireless. So again, it picked up your network. Although we did, I must say, we did have an issue with WPA, and I had issues at home. Now, it's probably documented, and again, a website, you might want to bring it up. It's called www.EEEuser.com. And this seems to be the fountain of all knowledge, and it's got a wiki and basically everything that you could want to know about the E.
Oh, they tell you how to put XP on it as well, because it runs Linux as well.
It does, yeah. I mean, by default, it comes with Linux, and obviously the benefit of that is Linux is not a bad operating system anyway, but the kind of thing that you want to do on here. But obviously, it's free. The distribution of it's free, so it helps cut down the cost rather than having to pay a license to Microsoft to say, for example,
because you couldn't even buy a Vista license for that, could you?
No, but what is interesting is, and they were saying this, I think they announced this at CES, Asus were saying this is their best-selling product ever to date, and they're a pretty decent-sized company, and they announced that they will actually be releasing a Windows version of this, so straight out of the box, you will be able to have a Windows version for those that, for whatever reason, don't want Linux.
Yeah, I wonder... Well, that's going to have to be XP, though, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, yeah. But everyone says XP runs so well on this. So it's got a 900 megahertz Celeron processor, which sounds awful. But if you think about it, XP's been around for so long now.
I was running XP on a 400 Celeron, and that was fine.
I was running my server on an 800 megahertz Celeron. So this is a 900 megahertz Celeron. It's got an integrated... GMA 900, which I think is the same as
Mac Mini, isn't it?
It's the same as in the Mac Mini. And I've been playing with this only for a couple of days now. I've got to say, mate, I'm bloody impressed. It's well built. It's quick to boot up, as we'll see.
It's solid state, I guess.
Solid state. The screen is bright. It's a good quality screen in here. And I guess I tell you what, should we get this thing set up? We've got to obviously set up the camera. We'll get the camera pointed at it, and we'll take an actual look at the interface and talk through it some more. Okay, Nikki, so what we've done is we've pointed the camera at a screen, and so it's looking a bit dark at the moment, but what we really wanted to also show people was how quick it was.
Yeah, that'd be interesting to see, actually.
So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to press the on button.
Right. Right, so I start timing from now. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's an interesting podcast. You basically hear me counting.
Learn to count with Nicky.
About 15 now.
And I think 20. A lot of it is, in fact, just the BIOS getting itself.
Yeah, I think you're right there, actually.
I think the operating system's pretty quick to start up. Well, as we can see, it's pretty quick there. What was that, about 30 seconds, would you say?
Yeah, I would say just under 30 seconds.
Yeah, a lot of people say about 20 seconds, 25 seconds for it to boot up. So.
And it's found our network.
So what we can see here is it's found a network point, and it's Fishnet, that's you, isn't
that's
it?
That's me.
So we're basically on the internet. So what we can see is it's booted up into what I would really call sort of a modified version of the Linux operating system, because it doesn't really reflect Linux as, well, certainly how I've played with it and seen it, and probably you as well. And more as, I think what Asus have done is they've taken the Zandros distro and they've modified it to give it a very simple sort of user interface, basically just to allow you to do the things that you want to do. So I guess it takes away that little bit, that sort of scariness of the Linux operating system. And what we see is it boots up and we've got these tabs across the top, so internet, work, play, settings, and I guess what this is giving us is access to applications that we're going to want to use.
And all these are on there as you bought it, yeah?
This is how it comes out the box. The only thing I have done is I've tweaked it a little bit from the console just to allow me to be able to boot up as a regular Zandros operating system, which we might take a look at if we've got some time at the end.
So you said this has got 4 gig?
This is a 4 gig hard drive, of which 2 gig is all the applications and the operating system, 2 gig for me to be able to write files to. So really this is an on-the-go kind of... create a few files. You're not going to be storing all your music and video files, not at that sort of size. But what I didn't point out earlier on was there's access to be able to put a memory card in here.
Okay.
So you can put sort of 4 or 8 gig very comfortably at a very reasonable price to store music files.
Is that an SD thing?
That's a good point. I should find out what it is. I think it is. I think it's an SD. And so obviously memory like that's very, very cheap. And it would allow you to extend it. So what do we get out of the box, I guess, is the question that you're asking, isn't it, Nicky?
It is.
So obviously what we've got is that we've got, these are our internet-y type applications straight out of the box. So internet, and that's provided by good old Firefox. And as we can see, it's utilising the network and things like F11 to give us a bit more screen. Now, we've got a resolution here of 800 by 480.
Okay.
And it's actually quite, it's quite usable, isn't it,
yeah,
in terms of size? I mean, if I was to kill this off...
Again, what you've got to remember is this is cheaper than an iPhone. You know.
That's a very interesting way of looking at it. Let me go into iGoogle. So again, this is just my Google account, which should be configured up on here. Don't think there's anything too ominous.
I'm going to read your email.
I don't think there's anything too ominous. So this is my iGoogle account. And again, these buttons are just set up to very easily take you into the places you want to go.
And it does flash and everything, does it? So you can watch IT Idiots on it?
Let's go and take a look, shall we?
Because that's obviously one of the main things that our subscribers would be looking to do.
Yes, absolutely, is to be able to watch us on the go.
The number one podcast.
Number one podcast. Yeah. we're happy about
that. That just slipped out.
So this is IT Idiots. As you can see, it's a bit wider than 800.
Uh-huh.
But let's go across. Will it play?
Maybe not.
This is the Mac Show.
Oh, that's our other wonderful podcast.
Right, so...
So that's the main thing.
Yeah, you can basically stream Flash straight out of the box. The default website is the E website, and I really, really think that this machine, or this concept of a machine, has got a future. And in fact, the reason I know that is because loads of other companies have now announced that they're going to be bringing out E-esque machines. And I think that under £200, and I think in a year's time, this particular machine will be sub £100.
I'm still confused how cheap it is. You know, it's £200 and you've got quite a lot of... Well, it's quite a nice gadget for £200, isn't it?
I mean, this is... A few years ago, you would have been paying a premium.
Exactly, to get it small.
This would be running at probably £1,000 worth of machinery only 2 or 3 years ago.
Yeah, looking to the future, thinking, yeah, it will be solid state, no hard disk, no movable parts. It's going to be expensive.
It's crazy, isn't it? So... yeah, there we go. I mean, we've got lots of internet access, and as you quite rightly pointed out, it's even got built-in Skype. Now, I haven't set up a Skype account, but I do know that it's... I haven't got one set up on here that I've logged into, but I do know it works.
Yeah.
I was using it earlier on, yesterday, I think, to have a quick conversation with somebody.
One of the other podcasts I listen to, I guess they must be lower than us in the rank.
Okay.
They've actually... One of the presenters actually... used one of these.
Oh, right. Oh, okay. That's quite good. So, yeah, that's the internet-type application. So, internet radio, world clock. Now, it's also got some work applications by default out of the box. And things, again, on the go that you want to do.
And this is basically OpenOffice, isn't it?
It is. Yeah. Now, I know that... I think you were saying that it's come in for a little bit of criticism.
I've read some... But again, you can't argue for £200.
It's harsh, man. It is harsh, I think. Things like, you know, you can take a snapshot of screen captures, all sorts of things that you'd want to do. But out of the box, look, there you go.
Mm.
It's all just built in.
I think
information managers.
Yeah, I think some of these people, when they're reviewing it, lots of people review it and they think, well, you know, I wouldn't be able to write a million word thesis on it. Well, you're never going to do that anyway, are you?
It's not what it's for, is it?
No, not at all.
This is the kind of thing that you don't need to feel embarrassed about whipping out in Starbucks to just quickly check your email. It's a portable device.
Exactly.
Rather than carrying around a great big laptop that, let's be honest, the people who are writing in the forums and saying, but for only another £150 I can buy a fully fledged PC, you're not getting
it's a different thing, isn't it? Yeah.
It is a completely a different thing. Firstly, it's another £150, which to a lot of people could be the difference between having a computer and not having a computer. Mm-hmm. And it's a fully fledged laptop. And let's face it, at the £400 end, you're buying a fairly big box. They're not the lightweight type machines. They're generally quite bulky.
Sure.
I mean, you've seen and been able to, you've had the benefit of being able to pick this thing up. It's light, isn't it?
It's light, and the first thing that struck me is how well made it was. I thought it was going to be a cheap, creaky, plasticky thing. I mean, it is plastic, but it is...
It's solid.
It's good. It's nice solid. And solid, yeah.
And you saw how quickly that came up. And, okay, I've got an external keyboard connected up here, so I don't keep knocking the machine. Instead, I'm not the camera. But, I mean, you saw how quickly OpenOffice fired up there.
It seemed fine to me, yeah.
So I think people are being a little bit harsh when they sort of knock it. And again, things like mail, I think this is a nice little feature. You go into, you can set this up, and it's got Mozilla straight out of the box. So look, we all know, we all use Gmail as hip young people. So again, you connect it up, and it's going to sync up with your Gmail account. It's got dictionary, notes.
Oh, Gmail supports IMAP now, doesn't it?
It does.
IMAP 4, so you don't have to worry about this thing sucking all your mail down.
Nope.
So.
It's got a learn tab. I haven't really played around with this very much, but I guess it allows you to learn things.
You can learn science now.
Should we learn some science? I have no idea what that means. Oh, it's got planetarium built in.
That could be quite useful if you get lost.
It's downloading data. Loading star data. I take it that's using your internet.
I wonder if you can put Google Earth on this.
Well...
Oh, no, it's an application, isn't it?
Yeah, but you say that.
It's Linux, isn't it? At the end of the day.
Yeah. I mean, I will show you this. I'll show you this when I reboot into... It will reboot into a Linux operating system that you will recognise. Welcome to the desktop planetarium setup. Sorry, as you can see, we've not... this allows you to move windows around, because obviously it's a limited size display. And I guess this allows you to be able to set up your location, and it'll tell you out the window what I guess you'll see tonight. But I won't waste people's time by setting that up too much. But again, it's not bad for out-the-box type stuff, is it?
No, but I'm more interested in the Play Tab.
Oh, no, the Play Tab's got some all right stuff in
You've
here.
You've got to have some kind of lander game.
Now, obviously, we've got games. Let's start with webcam.
Boring.
Charming, isn't he?
And there's the camera pointing at it.
And there's the camera and us set up with it. But, I mean, again, built into this device, you've got a webcam. So, again, over Skype, you can have you can have a nice video chat. And if there are two of you with these, it's so easy just to turn it on, find the other person. And, again, it's a small little camera, but it does the job.
I mean, a webcam, they used to cost 50 quid anyway, didn't they?
Yeah, and you can record this as well. So you can do your own little sort of, and I guess upload this to YouTube type. So it's not bad for recording your own personal thoughts type podcast or sort of blog.
No, it's good.
And submitting video. I think it'd be good enough for John C. Dvorak. So media player, now that's M-Player. And I think, again, what you'll find is that this probably does cover a fair few codecs that will actually
work. Well, you were watching a
this.
Film in bed, you were saying the other day.
I beg your pardon. No, I was streaming iPlayer, because obviously the BBC now has this watch again for 7 days.
I'm so happy about the BBC iPlayer. I think they're so on top of it, aren't they?
So I'm streaming. I was just lying in bed playing with it, streaming a bit of television that I'd missed, more to play with it. So it's got media player built in. So again, onto that memory stick, if you're going away for a weekend or something, going on a trip... 8 gig, you can put quite a lot of TV onto 8 gig, assuming that you obviously have the rights to be able to do that.
Of course. ITV.
And your own home movies.
And your own.
So it's got, so you can, obviously it's got these managers to be able to manage these things, but let's go and have a look at games for Nikki. Let's show you Penguin Racer.
You must have played. Have you played all these, Nick?
Yeah.
I tell you what, a bit off topic while we're waiting. iPod games.
Yeah.
Really into those. Sonic the Hedgehog's out on the iPod.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It's amazing. Look, this is pretty good.
It's not bad 3D graphics, is it? Come on, off a small little... You're always going to get people that are complaining, but I think they're being harsh if they're knocking this machine. And I think
they might... So.
Let's do some stunts. Oh, no, maybe not. You tell I know what I'm doing, can't you? So, that's this penguin-y type racer thing.
It'd be interesting how XP runs on this, eh? How much actually memory has this got?
512, sorry, I didn't mention, 512 meg of RAM.
Okay.
It's got a slot on the bottom to be able to take that out, and I've got some spare Mac RAM lying around. It takes the DDR2.
Oh, does it really?
Yeah, so I'm going to put, I've got a 2 gig module, so I'm going to put 2 gig into it and run Windows. I'm telling you, XP is going
to... Well, you have to bring it back when you have it running on Windows.
I will do.
Definitely.
But I've seen on YouTube, you'll see a couple of small little videos that people have done. And I've seen XP run, dude, and it's quick.
Really?
It's quick to boot, it's quick to run. You've got to customise it a little bit so that it's not using so much in the way of hard disk cache. And there's a little application called Nlight.
Nlight, I use that work.
Which will strip it down and give you a really lightweight installation of XP. Settings, I mean, nothing really very interesting other than it comes with some antivirus if you want it. Voice commands, so you can voice enable using the machine, because obviously it's got a microphone built into it. Disc utilities. Again, nothing amazingly interesting, I don't think, but it just sort of shows how you've got access to the configuration that you would need on a day-to-day basis running it in what they call easy mode.
Yeah.
And let's face it, for 99% of the people that are going to buy this for an on-the-go type machine,
mm-hmm.
it's not bad, is it?
Straight not out at all, of the box. No.
Very cleanly laid out, nice icons, and does exactly what I think it's targeted to do for the money.
Yeah.
I think what we'll do is, should we just end this by booting up into full-blown Linux, just to show people it's got it?
Okay. I thought you actually do something to get full-blown Linux on it.
You do. You have to install a package, which I did from the terminal. But it was, there were instructions again on euser.com,
right.
And I did it with the instructions on this screen, as it were, browsing the internet. So you didn't have to take it offline to do it. Or
right,
anything. It was a couple of lines. And as you can see here, it allows you to switch between... This is much more like a...
Has this got a video out as well? A VJ out?
Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah, so I've been running it on my monitor, and it goes up to 1650 by 1200 as a resolution. So, again, you can put this on a onto a regular monitor.
Yeah.
You hook up mouse and keyboard, and, I mean, it's not bad for just doing the basic type stuff, which 90% of people do, which is browse the internet, write a few files. And as you can see here, we've got access to everything that we had before. But obviously, it's in a standard sort of interface that people are used to, and menu type system. So, and obviously with this, we can then install many types of applications and anything that's available for Linux. And in fact, there's some screen capture software. I think it might be a little bit too processor intensive for this machine, but I'd be interested to have a look, because in theory, you could do screen capture at on these little machines on the go. I am going to set up LAMP, which is Linux, Apache, MySQL, and PHP, just to sort of have a play around with doing some web editing. But I really like it. I think for a little gadget on the go, I'm certainly going to keep it. But like that, it's good enough for me to keep for the time being.
When you phoned up and you said you've got one, I thought, I can't really see the point of one of those, because I just don't need it. But now I can see it. It's
very quick to turn on, quickly check your email or browse the internet. I really like it. And it's got some gadget value. And
yeah, exactly. I think there's that. And you've got the Skype on it, and you've got webcam on it. And I'm just thinking, you could probably get a GPS thing for your car and do all this kind of crap, the stuff on it, couldn't you?
I can't see a downside for the kind of money that it's going for.
Not really.
And to be honest with you, as and if and when I get bored of it, eBay's your friend.
Exactly.
So I think that was a good enough demo. Should we wrap up the demo? Is there anything else you want to see on it before
To be honest, I don't really know so much about Linux, but I'm sure there'd be Linux people screaming, saying, can you show us this?
Well, I mean, it's Linux. That's a Linux box, isn't it? So anything that you can do on Linux, you can now do.
Can you install Ubuntu and stuff like that on this?
Yeah. There are some instructions, even the people who produced the network, the wireless Wi-Fi network adapter, there were some issues. And again, because it's the Linux-type community, they wrote a driver for Ubuntu people to be able to put Ubuntu onto this and have Wi-Fi. And I thought that was quite cool. So you've got a lot of people that are running Ubuntu on this.
I think I would keep it how it is, you know, because for £200 it's nice that... I think they've obviously put a lot of effort into designing the apps and designing the interface on it.
Yeah.
But maybe I'm just getting old and not techie enough anymore.
But I'm going to put Windows on this, and at work we've got some... we've got some high-speed printing machines that need to be connected up to a computer, and I'm just going to put Windows on this, and it would run the labelling software, this high-speed labelling software, and rather than having a big computer hooked up to it, this just sits on top of the label printer. Turn it on, it's very quick to boot, perfect, it's on the network, because obviously it's got a regular RJ45 socket on there to be able to connect.
It's got a modem in it as well,
isn't it? It's got a modem as well.
I remember them.
You can't go wrong, can you, mate?
Not at all.
So I think what we'll do is we'll reset up the camera and come back. Okay, well, I thought that went pretty well.
No, it's quite impressive, eh?
Yeah, now the one thing I have noticed, it's silent, isn't it?
Well, I can't hear it.
And I don't burn myself from touching it either.
My MacBook Pro, it gets so hot. That's one thing I've got to say.
I don't think it's just your MacBook Pro. I think it's all laptop. Well, they're not laptops anymore, are they?
No, they're notebooks.
They're notebooks. Yeah. So I think you put them on your lap, I think you cook your testicles.
You do, yeah.
So I think they're advising, if you want children, not to work with them on your lap. But I really like it. I thought it was, it's a bit off topic for the obviously the enterprise stuff, but people will, if you're new to our podcast, then you'll realise that from time to time we do these kinds of things when we find something interesting.
That's cool.
Well, that interests us anyway, yeah. And we think will interest other people. I'm figuring next week we'll be back to doing something a bit more enterprise. Well, we will be because we're about to film it.
We are. There's not pretending.
There's no pretending going on here. So, yeah, if you're new to the show, welcome on board and thank you for watching our show. And if you're a seasoned regular viewer, then obviously you know that we should have been rightfully at number one.
From the start.
Right, that's it. We're not going to go on about this anymore.
No.
I think we've had our 1 week of gloating. And
I actually emailed it around work.
Accidentally.
I said, "Works." Did I accidentally email that round? How embarrassing!
So anyway, some recognition for us, and I'm pleased at that. So I think until next week, we'll wrap this up and call it a day.
I think so.
All right, guys. Cheers.
Cheers. Bye.
Bye.
Himself to sleep tonight on his huge pillow.